Hello again. Let's crop me a little bit so block that pesky ass sun. Anyway, I'm taking advantage of day off. Woke up this morning, wasn't feeling my best, let's just say. So I a little more rest, started feeling better, and I was like, you know what, I gotta take these girls out somewhere. So I'm back once again here near Lane Basin, just right up over there. And if anybody watched my Fairy Angel Lakes video, that's that valley over there. The bowl's kind of tucked over to the right. But I decided, since snow line far receded, I'm actually gonna go to a mine back here. I'm sorry about the sun. I'm gonna go to a mine called the Little Gem Mine. Guy I know showed this to me last fall, about a year ago actually, and it was cool. But I was telling myself I want to come back when there's less snow. So we did it. We still found the miner's trail, but there was a couple inches of snow. But right now, no snow, except for way up high. So where I'm going, oh gosh, sorry. I'm following this trail. Can't really see it in the shot, but the hillside in front of me, it's a little miner's trail. Takes you up and over that rocky spot and back. And the mine is tucked back there. Probably about a mile from here. Not very far. Hopefully it won't be too much of a hassle to get to. And yeah, kind of looking forward to this. Now I'm excited that I'm out here. It also helps that I'm literally the only human around at the moment. It's glorious. And my God, I am so sorry about the sun. I should have been over here the whole time. Good Lord. I'm changing my plans again a little bit, not drastically, but so I was starting to climb up this here because that's where my original track went. Apologies for going right into the sun, but you can see it dips down to that little channel, and then we kind of skirted around that thing in front of me, but that was because there was snow, right? And it made the most sense to go that way because we could see rock, we could see more or less a path, and we knew we weren't going to be stepping into deep pockets like down here. I mean, you could, even if it didn't look like there was that much snow, there'd be pockets you'd step in up to your nuts or something, right? So what I think I'm going to do instead, I'm kind of surveying the land, as it were, heading to that spot right there, and I'm gonna see how nasty that climb actually is, what the boulders look like, because that would be, that's the direct path to that mine. So wish me luck. Let's see how this goes. I don't know if you were able to see that gaping void in the distance. Probably not. I have to get a little closer, but I'm approaching the mine. Found the convenient set of boot prints from someone else who had been back here somewhat recently. Snow's super firm. It's like spring crust almost. Definitely not complaining. And actually, kind of glad for the boot prints, because I mean, I have my original track, but a lot of rocks and boulders through here. And I do remember before we were kind of following, I felt like more over there and kind of circumventing, following the stream more. But that's okay. Let's take me directly there. Haven't had any real nasty traps yet, so it's all good, man. Right center of your screen there. Where are we at here? Doop. Right where my finger touched. That's in the mine. So obviously we're here at the mine shaft now. I'm not gonna go too far in. I didn't bring a headlamp or anything. I'm gonna go in as far as that little cart that you see that my dog is at right now. Rena, come here. Yeah, bitch you see in this setting on my phone, but there it is. I don't have a, not like I have a spotlight for anything like that. I have been in this thing before, that last time I came here. And I really should upload that video sometime. It's fucking hilarious. Because I'm filming behind the guy I came here with. And he's talking about the history of the mine, which I've kind of forgotten about. I mean, they call it a little gem mine, so I don't think they're mining for like gold and silver. I think they're actually getting some kind of aggregate out of here. Anyway, I'm following along, and I'm not paying attention where my head is, and I mean, you can kind of tell that it's potentially low clearance in some spots. Well, I smacked my head, my forehead, around some granite, and you hear it in the video. You hear this slap. I stumble a little bit. I never uploaded that video. Never did anything with that video. So, if I decide to do it, I'll put it right here. While I'm sitting here paused, like, there's weird sounds coming from. So, I think I'm gonna get the fuck out of here. The way the water dripped in there sounded creepy as shit. Anyway, yeah, I'm gonna pack up, skedaddle, but check that out. I mean, this is well hidden back here. Well hidden amongst all the boulders. Matter of fact, you don't see it until you're most of the way through the boulder field before you see the opening. So, back to it. I'm deviating from my path a little bit. And I purposely don't have my super steady on. You'll see why in a second, but I had to show you this. Old bed. You're talking about a bed with a view, eh? Anyway, I don't feel like navigating boulders through the snow there. But let's see, right up there. Probably can't see, it's probably too blurry, but up there is a remnants of a bunkhouse. Like a canvas walled bunkhouse. It's really cool. Yeah. The back of it has like a brick wall that they built up to kind of built it and make it level. So up there is where I originally had come through. Like we climbed kind of up and over this down to where that bunkhouse is. Again, I mean, can't see it for shit on the camera and I apologize. And then we came down to the creek, followed the creek back to the mine. Now, I just wanted to get a shot of this bed. I forgot about this thing. But that is a really neat view, eh? Let's check that out again. But look at that. Look at that. Awesome. So, a couple thoughts on that route I just did. I think, first off, it is the better way to go. It's the more direct and certainly easier. There was no real path per se, but you didn't need one. You followed grass ramp up until you got into the rocks. Now, you know, coming through that ridge line, dipping down and then kind of circumventing around this guy, I think has its merits. One, you get to go visit that bunkhouse, because you drop down right onto it. And also, in the winter time, or maybe not necessarily winter, because you can get back here in the winter time, but it's definitely more risk adverse, let's say. There is like still a path. There's still like a miner's path through parts of that section. So I could see where that's ideal, but I think if there's no snow and you want to go back there, I think this is the way to go. Now, the other thing to, what I'm standing in right now was probably under snow and then later on underwater for a while until things dried up. So that's something to consider. Now, how wet do you want to get your feet? Also, there's parts that I was climbing up there that I'm pretty certain probably had water flowing through it as well. So I think there's probably multiple branches that are coming off of that when the snow is really melting. So another factor to consider. But I think if I'm coming back here like in the fall or late summer, what I'm on right now, where I'm at right now, is the way to go. It's certainly easier. It's more straightforward. I mean, not that I really aim to seek out the easiest paths, but if this is something I'm wanting to kill some time with, podunking around at the mine, eating lunch, I was still back hiking again and still under 2 hours from the car. So, you know, if I'm wanting to, arm's getting tired. So yeah, if I'm wanting to really like kill myself, then okay, do that up and over ridge thing, up and down, gain more elevation, etc. But otherwise, I think, I think this little bowl and up that's the meal ticket. That's the jam. That is the way. Insert whatever colloquialism you want. Anyway, I'm gonna work on getting back down to the main trail.